Well, Heidi Rue with Atlanta Voiceover Studio, thank you so much for joining us and adding your insights to our demo conversation. And we're excited. So I'm excited. Let's just jump right in. I'm going to start
Let's
with a
do it.
big
Let's
question.
dive in.
Big question.
Oh yeah, bring it. Bring it, bring
What do you think is the role of a demo in 2024? Is it just
it.
marketing, just to get an agent? Like, what's it for?
So I think that the big thing, it depends on your goal. So if your goal is to get agent representation, then yes, you obviously that is so vital. And the type of demo that you have is very vital for getting a good agent. But also these days in 2024, you don't need an agent to still have a really great voiceover career. So if that is not your goal, and that's okay if it's not, then a demo is important, but I would say it's mainly for marketing purposes. You've got to show the example on your website. And then I know we'll probably talk about this, but it's very important for your demo to be able to be separated into individual spots and samples so that way you can use that for online casting sites and for your website.
Perfect. So you said it's vital to have a different demos for different agents, right? So I think pretty much we can agree everybody needs a commercial demo, right?
Yes, 100%.
Do you think that it's vital for talent to have other demos, or is it just exclusively based on their goals?
So I think that commercial is the top priority. I will even say just personally, I mean, I'm with a great, I have several great agents and a manager. I get on animation auditions and video game auditions, and I don't have a demo. I don't have an animation demo. I don't have a video game demo. So I think that the first priority should be getting a really good commercial demo. And I wouldn't worry about that. If you're just getting started into voiceover and you're trying to get representation in New York or LA, I would not worry about spending extra money on some of those genre-specific demos yet. I would focus first on the commercial. And then you can go from there. But we are big at Atlanta Voiceover Studio. We have three values that we use to make all of our decisions. And one of those values that we use most of all is stewardship. So we think about that with talent that are coming here is okay, what type of investment are you able to make right now? What are your goals? And how can we best steward your money and your time to help meet those goals or at least take the next step? And so demos can be very expensive. And I also think I may be getting ahead of us, Alicia, but I also think, and I've seen so many talent that do this, is that sometimes it's a lot easier to throw money and do all these things of demos and classes and everything because that subconsciously, and look, we all do things like that, but subconsciously, it's easier to do that than take that scary step of actually sending it out and trying to get that representation or trying to get those jobs. It's so much easier and it feels more comfortable to do that. And so, our big goal at Atlanta Voiceover Studio is to give people the resources that they need to create the voiceover career that they want. And so, if you're looking for that resource, the first step is that commercial demo. That is the most important thing. And then from there, I do think it's important to work in other genres and to really train and develop, but start with commercial and then from there you can get into some of the other genres.
I love it. That's actually something I'm pretty passionate about, is I think so many voice talent get caught in what I call, because I'm a nerd, the spend cycle, right?
Love it.
They're just
Yes.
spinning their wheels, and they just keep throwing money, spending money, and trying, because it's something they can control. You can
Right, of
control
course.
how many demos you make, what your website looks like. You can't control whether somebody hires you, and that feels a lot scarier. So
Yeah.
what genres of demos do you produce there at Atlanta Voiceover Studio?
So specifically for us, it's commercial. That's our main one, but we also do like narration demos. We do IVR demos. And then we partner with some people. So we partner with an LA audiobook producer. who also has her own audiobook production company, and she's a narrator. So she'll do audiobook demos for us. And then we partner with Ariana and Real Voice LA to do the animation demos. So if anybody is interested in that, we do. But we really focus on commercial. And part of that is because Mike and I, that's where we make our most of our money and have had most of our careers in commercial. We are not animation experts. We're not video game experts. So we're not going to do those demos. But we've worked, so we've been doing demos now for almost 8 years. Wow. This summer, it'll be 8 years. And so we've really perfected kind of the system and how we do it. And so we feel really confident in our demos and in the process. And of course, we only want to offer things that are just of the best quality to students, and things that we think are going to help get them jobs.
So it sounds like you think it's important for demo producers to niche down a little bit to what they're really, where their strengths are. And by reaching out to other demo producers when you don't feel like you have that in your wheelhouse as much, that seems brilliant.
I mean, we have always said from the very beginning when we opened Atlanta VoiceOver Studio is that we are not the only people in town. Well, we kind of were almost the only people in town, but you know, we're not the only people that offer voiceover classes and do demos. And I've given people other commercial demo producer names to send them to. If they don't have the money to do a demo with us, I'm like, look, here's some people that you could get it for less. You're going to get what you pay for, you know, mm-hmm. from the producers. But listen, if this is what you need to get started, just go for it and do it. But we're big on saying that there is lots of people out there. We don't hold people tightly in our hands or think that we're the only people out there or the very best and there's nothing else out there.
We're it.
No, absolutely. And again, our goal is for people to create a great voiceover career. And so whatever it takes to do that, we want to help people do that. And we started Atlanta VoiceOver Studio because of needs. We didn't start off to be a studio or training facility or even do demos. I didn't want to do it. At least I was like, no, I do not want to do this. That came out really Southern.
I heard the Southern. It makes me happy.
When I get riled up, the Southern comes out. But we didn't start out to create classes or to do demos or anything. And we literally did it because people kept coming to us saying, we want to learn how to create a career in voiceover, and we don't know how to do that. And so we just started trying to commit to providing the best resources that we could for people.
I love it. So what criteria does a talent have to meet before you're willing to make their demo or feel like they're ready? And do you require a studio evaluation as part of that?
So are you talking about studio evaluation as like their home studio, like how it's sounding?
Yeah. Whether you record on location or at their studio, like do you make sure their studio is ready to go before you're going to send them out into the world with a demo?
So yes and no, as far as the studio evaluation goes. So whenever people come in, a lot of people that do demos with us are actually here in Atlanta. We do have mm-hmm. some that are separate. So they come into our studio to do it. And I know some people will say, no, you should do it from your home studio. But here's the problem that we saw that nobody else has talked about, at least, is that there were people that were only training virtually. They had never been directed, like they had never been in an actual like physical booth with somebody else directing right there. And I get it because that's how this world is. But for some reason, when people would come into the studio, even if they had a home studio, it was just throwing them off for some reason. And so we want them to have that experience of coming into the studio. And obviously if they don't feel comfortable, then they don't have to. But we always make sure. So, well, let me actually back up.
Yeah.
You may have to
ask too many questions all at once.
I'm like, wait a minute. We got to do. So let me start over. So what we do for our process is that anybody that wants to do a demo with us, even if they've taken all the classes from us, from Home Studio, from Beginner Intensive, which is a 3-month, you know, class, whatever that they've done with us, it doesn't matter. They all have to do a demo evaluation. And what that is it's a form that they fill out. They share a little bit more about like what their goals are, you know, their training. And then they also have to do several things. So one, they have to upload any samples that they have of stuff that they've done through classes or whatever. So we can hear, you know, how they sound, their delivery and all that stuff. But then they also have to record one line 3 different ways back to back so we can make sure that
they can do an ABC.
Exactly. Because if you get that demo and somebody books you, but you don't know how to do well in a booked session, then that's not going to be good for you. We want you to have those repeat clients, and that's how you do that. So that's one of them. And then another one is another line, 3 different ways, but 3 varying energy levels. So
I like that.
That was one of the things that we noticed too, is that people would be able to do, you know, just like they just kind of had the same energy throughout. And so we wanted to make sure that they were able to vary up the energy if they needed to, even if maybe that upbeat read isn't their like specialty or their sweet spot. We wanted to make sure that they could get there.
Right.
So again, if somebody's directing you and go, okay, this is great, but we need a little bit more energy, that they could do that. And then we also give them scripts to read and to upload so we can hear them doing different types of specs. So all of that information is giving us multiple things. One, we get to hear how your home studio sounds.
Yep.
And how your recording equipment sounds. Sorry, when you asked me if we do a home studio evaluation, I was like, well, no, not technically home studio, but we do kind of when the demo evaluations. But then also we can figure out, how does somebody sound without being coached? Because that's another thing. At the beginning, what we would do is if somebody else from Atlanta Voiceover Studio was somebody's coach and they said they're ready for a demo, then we're like, okay, great. You're ready for a demo. We trust this instructor. The problem is that they may do really well in a session with that coach, but if they got home and they couldn't do it themselves, we're like, this is not helping them. Because again, once you have that demo and you start doing auditions, you've got to be able to do that yourself at home without a coach. So yes. So basically, to wrap up, we do the demo evaluation, but several things that we are looking for to know if somebody is ready for a demo is, do you know your own range? So do you know what your sweet spot is? If we asked you, hey, you know, if when you email this agent, what are you saying that you can do for them? Are you just saying, I would love to be on your roster? Because that's what every single email is to an agent, and that's not okay. So make sure that you know what your range is. What do you bring to the table, and how can you get there on your own? That's very important. The other thing is to be able to do one line 3 different ways back to back. It cannot sound the exact same. We want to get you ready for those booked sessions. And then also be able to vary the range or the energy level. Sorry, not the range. And then also we look for somebody that is able to be directed very well. And we try and figure that out through the demo evaluation, first of all. But it's crazy. That has helped so much for people when they are ready for that demo, that it's just helped so much to go, okay, they are ready after they've all, you know, able to do all this stuff.
I love that. So often we talk about, when are you ready for a demo? And everybody's like, well, it's so personal, you know, I don't know. Oh. But it sounds like there are some really intentional things that you are evaluating at Atlanta Voiceover Studio. And that's, I think that's really, really great. So you guys,
I want to piggyback off what you just said. That annoys me when people are like, you'll know when you're ready. And I'm like, no, you won't. Because if you're getting started in voiceover, you have no idea what it means to be ready. You've never done a booked session. You don't know those things. So you won't know. And that's exactly why we were very specific in giving. These are the criteria. These are the things that we are looking for to know, so that you know when you're ready. And coaches know, now our instructors know, okay, these are the things that they need to be able to do. So
that sounds like a great video for Atlanta VoiceOver Studios social feeds. Self-evaluation. Can you do these things? If you can do these things, you might be ready for a demo. I love that. So you guys have coaching. I mean, one of our questions is, are you a coach? Yes, you are a coach. And do you require coaching as part of your process? If I came to you and I'd never done any coaching with Atlanta VoiceOver Studio, would you be willing to make me a demo?
So a lot of people come to us and they may not have been through Atlanta VoiceOver Studio. So that's why we do the demo evaluation. It really gives us an idea. You know, doing this for so long, what we've seen is everybody's different, ready at different points. So now I will say that I still to this day have never seen someone that could do like an intro to VO workshop and then be ready for a demo right after that. But I have seen people that have done the intro to VO workshop and then have done some private coaching and are just, they're there. They, most of them have been actors,
right?
You know, either on camera actors. So they already have a little bit of background, but rarely is anybody ready for a demo right after the intro to VoiceOver workshop. So, so as far as the answer to your question, I mean, we have those classes set in place, but it's never like, oh, do this class and then you'll be ready for a demo. It's these are the classes that we have in order to prepare you for that. And everybody's going to be different as far as when that point comes. And also some people don't like to do the classes. Some people just like to do the private coaching. And so it just kind of depends on the person.
Yeah. And some people might come and just do coaching with you and you wouldn't mind if they went and did a demo somewhere else.
It's
a package that you have to buy.
Oh, absolutely. No. The only thing that I will say that we have ever done that actually has worked out is we've done a long weekend workshop for audiobooks where they did get a small demo at the end. And that's for multiple reasons. Everybody already had to have VO training before they even went into the workshop. So everybody already had a really good foundation. Mm-hmm. It was only one sample. There's not production, you know, a lot of production that had to go on for that. So that was something that we did do. And it actually worked out great. And we've done one for e-learning as well. That actually worked out really, really well. But we never include that in other things. But we have tried with some of the smaller, like genre specific things.
I actually really love the idea of a workshop or a class series that you end with a sample, because it feels like I've accomplished this and then I can take that and I can do something with it. That's nice. But it's nice to know as well, you're not selling like, if you take these six courses at the end, you'll be ready for a demo unequivocally, and we will make you one and you will walk away master. And you will book all the work, you know.
No, but that sounds awesome though,
doesn't
right?
It? Sign me up. I mean, there's those, we see those on social media. They do exist, but I don't think anybody's really, it's not a guarantee. There's no guarantees in VoiceOver, right? There's no crying in baseball and there's no guarantees in VoiceOver.
Yes.
So can you tell me, do you feel like there should be some level of church and state separation between coaches and demo producers and casting? Like coaches should just coach and demo producers should just produce? Or is it a natural overgrowth of coaching that is where you end up making demos?
Yeah. You know, that's hard to say. What I will say is my perspective on it. And something that Mike and I have found is that we really think that it's a great thing that Mike and I are both voiceover talent that are creating this, because, or creating the demos, because we know what it's like to be in a booked session. We know exactly what those directors are going to say, you know, not exactly, but I mean, you know, we've had so many experiences with directors and creative directors And agents, and we have really good relationships, not only with our agents, but a lot of other agents. And so we know what those agents are looking for. And not only that, but Alicia, I bet you agree with this. It's like, if you're a voice talent, you've been doing it for a long time, your ear is so honed in on the different sounds and how to get there. And so I feel like, I just feel really grateful that we were, that it did work out, that we were able to provide demos. I didn't think I wanted to, but I really love it. And we are so committed to not only providing somebody a great demo that helps them get work, but the specifics of it, you know, we want to make sure that those demo pieces are going to reflect those brands. If they're actual, you know, brands that people recognize, we're not putting music behind there that's stock music that anybody on YouTube can use. You know what I mean? We are putting the music and the background on there that, like, I don't want to necessarily say a specific brand, but, you know, a big brand, that those types of campaigns, like, we look at that and go, okay, what is their current campaign and what does that sound like? And what are they, what's the feel? Because we want it to sound very real, very current. And then also we really are committed to making sure that it highlights that talent's sweet spots, but also, like, where do we think that, how can we have that personality of that talent shine through? So we write all of our scripts for the talent, specifically for them. So nobody has the same demo. And we include a lot of personal things. Like, there was one talent that we did a demo for, Lauren, and she had this Pomeranian named Marilyn. And we included Marilyn in one of the spots, and it was so fun. And when you are able to personalize it, it automatically adds that connection for the talent. And so they're able to connect to it a little bit more and personalize it. And we think that it makes it even better. But then we also really care about the order of the spots too, because we know that those first few spots are really important. And we know, because we are talking with our agents and talking with other agents, we know exactly what they currently are looking for. And so we try and go, okay, what aligns with this person's sweet spot and what agents are looking for, and how can we showcase that at the very beginning? I over-explained so much of that, Alicia. I am so sorry.
No, it's but great. You answered several of my questions
all at once
in a beautiful way. No, it's great. Oh, okay. Stop apologizing. You're giving it, you just gave us more than we asked for. That's who complains about that. I love it. But I do want to know, so you say you custom write your scripts. So you and Mike write the scripts, or do you hire copywriters, or how does that work?
So kind of both. So Mike and I, from the very beginning, have written the scripts, and Mike actually was a copywriter in radio when he started off, as well as on air. And so he's a great writer. And I love writing as well. So I really have taken over a lot of the writing. But what we realized was, before, we were so slammed with demos that it was so much of our time that we had like 4 months waiting period to get in to do a demo. So what we did is we trained some of the other instructors that were interested in, because they already coach, they already instruct, and we just trained them on how to write scripts. What do we look for? How do we coach people? How do we direct people? So now we have several scriptwriters that have been trained by us. And then one of those scriptwriters is an actual copywriter. He's a coach, he's a voice talent, but his main job is a copywriter he did MailChimp's, you know, things. So there's a lot of people to choose from. And so at this point, what we've done is, so our regular commercial demo is $1,400 with one of those scriptwriters. But if you've done a beginner intensive class with us, you do get $150 off credit. So because it's 3 months, we wanted to, like, say, hey, good job. You did a 3-month class. We want to be able to try and give you a little something extra for that. So $150 off. And then if you want Mike and I, it's $1,900. So it is a little bit more to get us, but we still do it. And we love doing it. We get really excited about it, but.
And I'm betting you still have your fingers a little bit in some of those other demos, right? Like
Oh yeah.
listening,
We listen to
feedback.
them. Yeah.
We've kind of covered the bulk of it, but walk us through your production process. I've done your demo evaluation and I'm like, you said, okay, you're good. You're ready to make a demo, Alicia. You've done the hard work. What comes next?
So first of all, one of the things that we really try and do well is communicate very well throughout the process, because you've probably been through demo processes too, where it's like you may start or you may put a deposit down and then you're like, you wait time and you're like, what's happening? When is this going to happen? You know? So we try and really communicate very well. So once somebody fills out the demo evaluation, we say we will get back to you within 7 days or less to let you know if it's like green light, let's go. Okay, so then we get back with you. We let you know exactly what's going to happen next. But in order to start the process, we ask for 50% deposit, just so that we know that you're invested, you're going to do this, you know, we're good to go. 50% deposit, and then we start writing the scripts. And then we say, listen, we try and write the scripts within a week time, but we say, give us at least 2 weeks, but usually it's not that long. We just try and
have a buffer.
All of our script writers, again, are like full-time voice talent, you know, so we just want to make sure that there's a little buffer there. And then we send you the scripts for you to look over, see if there's any other questions or anything like that. And then we set up a recording time. And that's just based on whatever time you have available. We ask for about, you know, 2 hours, but it usually doesn't take that long to record your demo. But we just say, give that, you know, give us a little
Lock
bit
it
of
out.
Time. Yep. If you're doing it from your home studio or another studio, we do, even though we've already done the demo evaluation, we still have you send us another sample just to make sure that everything sounds really good and broadcast quality and stuff. And our sound design engineer, Rochelle, will listen to that and evaluate it. And then you come in, or you do it from your home studio, and we direct you through the process. Once that's done, then we talk about the order. And then we actually have, so we can do it in-house as far as adding the music, but we've worked with a producer from the very beginning who his full-time job is actually producing commercials.
Oh, wow.
So he and us have just been like this. We are on the same wavelength on all this stuff. And so he adds in the music, and a lot of times we'll give like specifics of what we hear, or, you know, the vibe and what we're thinking and stuff. He adds that in, does the final mixing. And then we say, give us like a week to 2 weeks before we get the final produced product to you. It's usually less than that. And then once we have it all ready, that's when we ask for the balance to be paid. So you do have a little bit of time too between that deposit and the balance, which is really helpful if you just need to space out that the payment. Mm-hmm. And then once we do that, then we send you your fully produced demo plus each individual fully produced spot. One of the things that we do with our demos that wasn't done in the past, and I hope that things are changing, but before it used to be like little segments, you know, and they squeeze it together, it wouldn't be full spots. Mm-hmm. And because we write the spots, we write about like a 10 or 12 second spot. So from start to beginning. So it doesn't feel like it's like in the middle
like
of the spot.
Cut off.
And the reason why we do that is because we want you to be able to have that fully produced spot at the end to where you can add to, you know, online casting or your website. And so that people can hear the turn that you make in those commercial spots. They can hear you from the start to the beginning, as depending on where you like cut in on a spot, that's going to have a different feel. And so we want you to be able to demonstrate that you can go with the flow, that you know the turn, that, you know, all that stuff. And then not only that, but we also send what we call the demo follow-up PDF. And that is packed with information. It's packed with, what do I do with my demo once I get it? How do I use it for online casting sites? Tips for online casting sites, tips for emailing agents. How do you send your demo? How do you email your agents? Some specifics on that. And not only that, but we also list all the Atlanta agents and their submission policies. We lay it out for people. Like they should have, and then also how to use it to self-market. So we lay out all that information. And I cannot tell you how many times people have done a demo. We've included that demo follow-up PDF. And then like a few months later, they were like, hey, so what exactly am I supposed to do with this? And we're like,
did you read them?
we like gave you a platter of like exactly what to do with this. So, but that is very important. And I say that just because if you do a demo with us, or, you know, if you have in the past, just don't forget that that's a really crucial piece of information and really helpful tool for you.
It sounds like it's another piece of that stewardship too. Like you're not just handing someone a demo. You want to make sure that they're empowered with the skills to use it. And I know you have email lists that go out in newsletters. They have all sorts of great tips and ideas. I love them. I think they're great. Everybody should be on that newsletter list. So let's move on to, are you open to collaborating with the talent? So let's say a talent comes to you. I'm like, I already have my copy. I paid an ad writer. Copywriter on my own, and I love it. I just need you guys to direct and produce me or record it in your studio or whatever. Are you open to that kind of collaboration?
So, to some degree, yes, but some degree, no. We take a lot of pride is not the word. Sorry, I'm like, that's not the word.
Stewardship.
In just the process of the demo, that how we do it. And so any type of commercial demo that's come through Atlanta VoiceOver Studio, we want to know that it has been quality from the very beginning all the way to the end. So it's kind of more that, but also we have a recording studio with a great sound design engineer who is awesome. So if you pull scripts, if you know the music that you want to use and you want to come and record it with us, that's fine. You know, you can just pay for the recording time and get it all done. Again, it's like everybody is so different. And there are people that don't have $1,400 to spend on a demo, but they want to get at least something out there to get started. And so if that's the case, then we want to be the place that you can come to record. We just won't, it won't be the same, you know, it won't be Atlanta VoiceOver Studio produced demo. It's just you're paying to come in and record with us and have our sound design engineer. So.
Perfect. Okay. So in the time you've been producing demos, or even just in your career, because your career spans farther back than producing demos, what shifts have you seen in the industry regarding demo production?
So one of the biggest things is, of course, the samples, like the individual samples. When we started doing demos, you know, 8 years ago, everybody was only giving people the fully produced demo that we knew of, because we had talent that would come in with the fully produced demo. And we're like, oh, do you have the individual spots? And they're like, no. So we did that from the beginning, and we've seen where more people are doing that now. But even the reason that we did it back then was because if your agent said, hey, I love your demo, but we have these one clients, they really like this type of read, I would love for this spot to move to the front. It's way easier to do if you have each individual spot from your demo. Or maybe you book some really great thing and you want to include that on your demo. And you're like, oh, I can just move this, you know, insurance spot out and put this one in. It just makes it a lot easier. So that's one of the things. I will say that I don't know if it's something that has changed, but it's something that we've just been really dedicated to. And it really speaks to the whole studio. I don't want to say there's some people. We are really committed to being a place that supports and encourages voice talent. And I know there are people that out there that will be like, you know what? If somebody's not cut out for this industry, I'm going to tell them, and I'm going to say, I'm not doing your demo and you don't need to be in this industry. And that is something you will never hear from me. And I don't believe it because there are also people that I've seen come through that if you told me at the very beginning that when they were in class, and I may have been like, you know, I just don't think that they're cut out for this. Some of those people have then gone on to book national spots and have done just fine. And if somebody came to them and said, you're not cut out for this, and they quit, I could never live with myself with that. And, you know, there are some people that, you know, may not have the talent, but they have the business insight, you know, they have the drive and they're going to do just fine, or they're going to find their way in this industry. And so I think that for demos, my goal in it all is to, for somebody to walk away and feel really empowered and feel like their demo reflects the best parts of them and what they can do to shine and bring to this world, into this industry. So I don't know if that's something that's changed, but it's something that we've always been committed to. And it's something that I haven't always received from coaches or, you know, throughout my career, but it's something that I want to make sure that we do here.
I'm with you. I've had an experience where someone was like, if you're even booking, it's only in this read or whatever. And it funny thing is, it wasn't even a read that I book in, or I do now, but I didn't then. And I was like, if you're even like, that's all I heard from that whole conversation. I want to make sure that people don't get that experience. So I think you've already answered this question quite effectively, but I want to give you a chance to any last things. Why should a talent choose to work with Atlanta VoiceOver Studio specifically?
You know, I do think I kind of shared a little bit through that, but you don't have to. You know, there's a lot of other demo producers. We just know exactly how we're committed to this process and how we want to make you shine. And, you know, it's honestly, once we started doing the demo evaluation, we used to have a 3-month waiting period, and now it's like, no, you could probably get in tomorrow. We've had so much less demos because of that, but it doesn't matter because we're committed to producing great stuff and to being supporters and encouragers of talent. And if that means that we don't get as much demos, then that's fine, you know?
And you're saying you don't get as many because you don't make them if they're not ready?
Yes. And because it's another thing for them to do. Before, what they had to do if they wanted to do a demo with us is they had to email me. And then I would ask them for some samples. I would send them some scripts, but it made it a lot easier for them to do. And now they have to fill something out and they have to record at home and do it all, you know, do it on their own. And that's a lot more work.
But if you're not willing to, I'm just going to say, if you're not willing to take that step, then are you going to do the steps that are needed to do the rest of your career? So take the steps, build out the form, people.
Right. Exactly.
Awesome.
I also wanted to say one last thing, is that, you know, as far as I know, you mentioned collaboration earlier, but that's something that I love to do when I write scripts for people. Is there are a lot of times what I will do is, especially if someone I can tell has a really good sense of humor, then I try and bring that out in one of the scripts. And I love to improv. A lot of times what I'll do is I'll write a script out, but then I'll kind of have some examples of some things. But then I leave it open. So once we get into the directing or just even sending the scripts, I'm like, hey, listen, if you have another idea or if there's something that fits you a little bit better in this, then let's talk about that. Let's collaborate, or let's try some different things based on who you are and how you show up, because that's going to make an even better demo, you know, be a better reflection of you.
Yeah, it sounds like the collaboration really is throughout the whole process, from the beginning of evaluating whether you're ready to whether you like the scripts. And then I'm sure when you send a finished demo, if someone's like, you know, in my heart, I feel like these scripts should be reversed, then you will honor that.
Yeah. Yeah.
or at least have a conversation about it.
Of course, I will say that I am such a
Sometimes.
talker today,
That's
Alicia. I'm
okay.
sorry, you're going to be like, I'm never having her on again. But I will say something just as a warning to talent. If you do a demo and you play it for your friends and family, and then your friends and family are like, oh, I kind of like this spot better
Yeah.
at the front or whatever. And you come back to the demo producer and you're like, well, all my friends and family are saying that I really should do this one. Your friends and family are not agents. They're not agents. They are not voiceover casting people. They are not. So just know that when you say that, and we will do it, we've done things before, but we always explain, hey, this is exactly, we don't ever do anything that's not intentional. So the reason why we like order it this way and everything is because very specific reasons why. So just be careful if you're asking for feedback from people that aren't in the industry.
Love it. That's actually such a great point because they don't know the nuances of positioning and which spot goes where. There is a question that I forgot to ask you. I don't know where I hid it in my, anyway. When do you think that having a demo of mock work versus booked work became the standard, or has it always been the standard as far as you know?
So, and sorry, will you say that again? So you're saying
So
when
some
did.
people are like, why can't we just use booked work, like jobs we've done, put it together and make a demo, which I think now I'm learning from other demo producers is actually what is called a reel. It's a reel if it's officially booked work, but a demo is a demonstration of mock work. Is that all you've ever done, or do you sometimes do booked work, and why?
So we do a booked work. So what we have is besides just a regular demo, we also offer updated demos. So if you have stuff, from past demo or you want to include booked work or whatever, you can do that. That's just a separate process. Personally, for me, I have plenty of booked work to include on a regular reel, but even I have created, it's like a mixture of booked work and mock work. And the reason why is because there are things that are, well, there's several reasons, but one is there may be stuff that people are looking for these days, authentic, real, natural read or whatever. And maybe you don't have the best sample of that from a booked job. You still want to show that you can do that, right? On
Yeah.
your reel, you want to be able to demonstrate that. And so then that would be a reason for a mocked spot. And then the other thing is that sometimes it just, the regular work, there's not like a good cutoff point, or it's too long, or I mean, there's a lot to it. And I just feel like you can, because attention spans are so short these days, that sometimes I think that the mock stuff is better because you can tailor it. You can really pack a punch in a really short period of time where you may not be able to do that with some of your booked work.
Great answer. I love that. All right. Well, Heidi Rue, Atlanta VoiceOver Studio, thank you so much for your time. And we will say goodbye.
Okay.
I'm such a nerd saying goodbye.